Hello everyone. As you know, that war between Russia and Ukraine is ongoing and every day it is taking a new turn. I want to show you what is happening on Twitter. So these are the keywords which people are typing a lot on Twitter. As you can see that people are speaking about NATO and also speaking about stop the war in World War 3. People are also going up with these many words. They want to speak these words on the Twitter. They're speaking about America, they're speaking about their ex-president, they're speaking about their current president, and they're speaking a lot about other things. So people are speaking in multiple languages. As you can see, English was the most spoken languages on Twitter. So I have taken this data and there are approximately 10,000 tweets. So out of 10,000 tweets, 75,000 tweets were made in English. This is a little bit of sentimental analysis which I have done. Which is a sentimental is between the subjective and the polarity. Subjective is more like a belief or maybe your expression towards something. However, polarity is about your emotions, whether it's negative or positive emotions. Based on the polarity, I have plotted a bar chart based on whether you were negative or you were positive or you were neutral on Twitter towards this war between Russia and Ukraine. These are the most liked and retweeted tweets. As you can see, the first tweet is a very negative tweet. It was done by the Ukraine themselves, which is saying that, hey people, let's demand to remove from here. No place for an aggressor like Russia on Western social media platform. They should not be allowed to use these platforms to promote their image while brutally killing the Ukrainian people. So this was the most liked tweet done on the Twitter and also a very highly retweeted. Thank you so much, people. Hello everyone. This is the Python code for Twitter sentimental analysis, which I have done on the topic of Russia versus Ukraine war. You can find a link for the data set on the video description. I will now start with the code. So first I have imported all the libraries which are required for the analysis. Secondly, I have uploaded the file name. I have printed the head. So what all data type we have? We have a tweet ID, we have a conversation ID, we have when it was created, date and time, finally the time zone, user ID, username, name of that person, the place, the tweet itself, the language which was used, whether someone was mentioned, URLs, photos, count of replies, count of retweets, count of likes, hashtags, cache tags, was there any link which was used, retweets were done or not, code URL, videos, thumbnails, near, geolocation, source, user right ID, user right, retweet ID, reply to, retweet date, translation, transsync, and transactions destination. So most of the data could be empty, but I have taken all the data for this analysis. So first of all, what I have done is I have defined a function which is hashtag extractor, which has taken all the hashtags mentioned in the tweets. Finally, I have plotted a bar plot in for these hashtags against their own counts, kind of a frequency of the hashtags, how many were used, and this was the result. So as you can see, out of the 10,000 tweets, approximately 68,000 tweets were made on Russia, which is hashtag Russia, and 50% of them were made on Ukraine. Finally, I have cleaned the data and plotted all the data, which is like cleaning the tweet column, because I would like to do sentimental analysis next. For this sentimental analysis, I have also I have to do subjective and polarity as well. It is a part of sentimental analysis. I have also done a cloud, word cloud of this data of the tweets, what people, which type of keywords people were using on the Twitter. So as you can see, there were a lot of Russia, Ukraine, in different multiple languages has happened, but there were other topics as well which has been used during these conversations. speaking about languages, English was the most common language which was used during the tweets. However, there were other languages as well. So I have just provided a simple bar plot using the language column which was available. Now I have a score for polarity and subjectivity. Where is it? Yes, over here. So I did this subjectivity and polarity over here. So I defined very simple functions which were inbuilt of text block library, and from there I have parsed my tweet column and I have created two new columns in my data set, subjectivity and polarity, on for every tweet. So subjectivity is basically belief in the views which people speak about, keywords like they express themselves, and other keywords make higher subjectivity. However, polarity is more on the emotions world, like we hate, bad, killing, love, joy, and celebrations. These keywords define polarity. So if the polarity is negative, that means the tweet had some false language being used, or some hatred language, or not even hatred, but something which was you know, like a bit about negative, bit about not joining, not loving, but more of a backward negativity thing. Not here because it's a war topic. I don't think so that the negative keywords are really negative, because they could be about, you know, killing, they could be about war, and war itself is a negative word. Therefore, we have to be very open about polarity in specific, in these type of topics. We have covered languages, and now based on polarity and subjectivity, we have made another column which was analysis, and in this analysis we have given positive and negative it, and neutral as well, based on their polarity. Simple if else statements. Plotting a scatter plot based on the polarity and subjectivity, most of them were coming at 0 by 0, but it's a huge spread. So people have actually expressed a lot on Twitter. Finally, plotting a bar plot on the sentimentals. 50% of them were neutral, around 30% the people are positive, and the more than 20% are negative on the sentimental score. Lastly, these are the most used liked tweets. This is the most liked tweet, so which was done by Ukraine on, hey people, it's time to remove from here, no place for an aggressor like Russia on Western social media platform. They should not be allowed to use these platforms to promote their images while brutally killing the Ukrainian people. So 54,000 likes were done. It was in English language, subjective 0.35, polarity was negative, but a lot of likes were done, and same tweet got a lot of retweets. Thank you so much. I will share this code in the description. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much.